So previously we talked about unresponsive software and what were the consequences of building unresponsive software. We gave some concrete examples of situations where particular companies had encountered a situation where they had unresponsive software. Now what we want to do is we want to delve into the opposite. We want to talk about responsive software and what it means to be responsive, and we want to try to come up with some concrete examples of that. So as what we want to do is we want to think about the following questions. What are cases where you have encountered responsive software? This is going to be a little trickier to come up with compared to the unresponsive case. It's very easy to see unresponsive software. We notice that right away. It's a little harder to notice when something is responsive, but do your best to try to come up with something. What was your impression of that software? Do you think it was using reactive principles behind the scenes, for example? Then we also want to think maybe from our own personal perspective and say, have we ever built software that leveraged some or all of the reactive principles? And what benefits did we get from the reactive principles? Just to get us kickstarted again, I'll give you an example that I'm aware of. Netflix actually is something that gives a really good example of some responsive software. So if you look at Netflix, they have a couple of features. There's the My List feature, and then there's the Continue Watching feature. So, if you've got a TV show that you've been watching, you can go to the Continue Watching and it'll pick up where you left off. And then the My List allows you to record things that you want to watch later. So those are a couple of features that they have. What I have noticed a couple of times, and I've actually spoken to somebody from Netflix about how they implement this, so I know that my assumptions about it are correct. But what I have noticed is sometimes you'll go log into the Netflix user interface, and the My List feature or the Continue Watching feature are just gone. They don't appear in the user interface at all. Now, what I had originally theorized, and again had somebody from Netflix confirm this for me, was that what has happened in that case is they have a portion of their application that has either crashed or become unavailable for some other reason. Maybe it's a database migration or something, but that portion of the application is unavailable. And because that portion of the application is unavailable, those features become unavailable. Now, the reason that this is a good example of reactive systems and the reactive principles is because the application itself still remains responsive. You can still go into the application, you don't get any error messages at all. You can still, if you want to watch your TV show, you can search for your TV show, you can still watch it. There's nothing preventing that. You can do all of the things that you could do before. You can watch your shows, you can continue watching your shows, you can do all of those things. You just lose a couple of menu options. And so this is a very good example of one of the ways that you can maintain responsiveness even despite a failure. You maintain resilience by reducing the number of features that the user has available in a very transparent way. The user doesn't even see that there's an error at all. All they see is those menu options are now missing. What's interesting about that is if you were a user who wasn't planning to use that feature, you were just going to log in and pick a movie out of one of the other lists, then you probably won't even notice that that option is gone. You won't even see that that option has disappeared. It's only if you are going to use that specific feature that you will actually notice it. So for the vast majority of users, there's no impact at all. And then for the small subset of users who were looking for that particular feature at that time, they have a slightly limited access to the functionality that they were trying to achieve, but they haven't lost the entire application. They just are restricted somewhat. So that's a good example from a real-world scenario that you might be familiar with. So take a few minutes, think about these questions and how you have encountered them in your day-to-day, and then we'll go through some other examples shortly.